very much. And good evening. We'd like to quickly get started by doing something from the MF Horn 2 album. We feature the All-American trumpet section back here, and the first two soloists of the evening from London, England. Say hello to Andy McIntosh on alto saxophone. Andy? And on drums, also from England, say hello to Randy Jones. Randy Jones. This is an original composition of mine and Alan Downey's, and we call it Give It One. This is Jeff Steinberg's original composition, and we introduce for the first time this evening, from New Zealand, would you say hello to Goose Johnston on baritone saxophone. Goose Johnston. And on tenor saxophone from Holland, say hello to Ferdinand Hovel. Ferdinand Hovel. And at the electric piano from Oldham, England, say hello to Pete Jackson. Pete Jackson.
Let me say something.
And we have a very wonderful lead trumpet player, better known to all of the Italian lovers as the Enforcer. Would you say hello to Lynn Viviano on the Italian player? We call this one Nice and Juicy.
Thank you.
We'd now like to dedicate a number. This is from one of the Columbia albums. And it's we'd like to dedicate it to Sandy Sandberg and all the Holton guys. Here's Bridge Over Troubled Water. do a elongated version of one of the most requested things in our book. It's from the original M.F. Horn album, and we feature for the first time this evening on trombone, say hello to Randy Purcell. Randy? And we hear from Lynn Viviano, again on trumpet, and Goose Johnston on baritone saxophone. And most of all, we'd like to feature our very exciting drummer, Randy Jones. This is, a hand for Randy Jones. This is MacArthur Park.
Thank you. Thank you.
Maynard Ferguson.
Thank you. composer and arranger, Pete Jackson.
Now we'd like to do a Don Mensa composition that's designed to feature two saxophones. We'll hear from Bruce Johnston and Ferdinand Vogel. And this one's called Two for Oats.
Thank you.
Rosa Johnson. Ferdinand Coble.
Jackson arrangement. Our band, which is, of course, truly international right now, we do a lot of playing in Europe, and particularly a lot in Italy, which is probably why we selected this next ballad. And we'll hear from Randy Purcell on trombone, Bruce Johnston on baritone saxophone, and this is Pete's arrangement, and we feature Pete at the electric piano, and here's the love theme from the Bellacci papers.
Thank you.
Ferguson. And Pete Jackson. Thank you. Now we'd like to do a Michael Benny original composition. This is something that we re-recorded just recently. And it's designed to feature two trumpets. And we'd like to bring Bob Summers down to the front of the bandstand and offer an introduction. Bob Summers! We call this the Fox Hunt. I didn't design this one. At first I thought it was a tie pin. That's a great little instrument. I must learn to play it someday. And it's a pocket cornet.
And
incidentally, that over there is called the MF Superbone. And if your mother or your wife's with you, don't explain it. However, the guy that is responsible for the designing of that instrument is probably with us. He's from the Holton factory. But also his mother and father were here to make sure that I played it on at least one number, which I did. And Mr. and Mrs. Ramirez, and also Larry Ramirez. So we'll dedicate this next number to them. And it's a form of a jazz spiritual. This is something that we re-recorded recently. We have a live album that'll be coming out. It's a double album, and I guess it's about the end of September. And would you believe MF Horn 4 plus 5? And this is one where we feature the blues playing of Bruce Johnson. Is that microphone on, Bruce? And we also feature Ferdinand Popel on tenor saxophone playing the part of Billy Graham. Features everybody, and it's called Got the Spirit. Mm-hmm.
Grace Johnson. Grace. Ferdinand Popo.
I think it's important that you meet some of the men you may not have met unless you were at the clinic today. First of all, our bass trombonist, say hello to Graham Ellis. Graham? And we're very fortunate to have two finely accomplished players. Would you say hello to Danny Kahn? Danny? And another fine trumpet player from Chicago, say hello to Jean Deflon. Jean Deflon. And our bassist, say hello to Rick the Thrum. Rick the Thrum. This is Loretta Heights, right? Okay. Well, I once, through an accident of fate and all sorts of things, I was part of a, I was sort of a guest here when this place first opened, and Loretta Heights was being helped by MGM Studios in Hollywood. Some of the older folk here may remember the incident, because it was rather beautiful. It was like William Lundigan and J. Carroll Nash and George Murphy and Mickey Rooney and a whole bunch of people came from Hollywood, and they premiered a picture downtown, and they had a typical Hollywood bleak light thing with all the people screaming and yelling, and that was that. Then the next night was an in-person performance. I believe it was the first one held on the stage, and I was with these people for one reason or another. And however, I was hardly to be called a Hollywood movie star. But if anybody ever knows anything about journalism and the way there's one guy who just sifts through whatever he thinks looks like the biggest ham to put on the front of the Rocky Mountain News, is that it? So instead of George Murphy, instead of, they sent me up, and I said, no, I'll just go in the sideway. You know, I'm just here as a guest. They said, no, come on up there. And so the humor of it all hit me. This is in downtown Denver, and I was very young and silly then. And so I turned around the cameras, and I went like that. And so, believe it or not, in 1953, I was on the front of the Rocky Mountain News, and my mother and father were very excited because underneath my picture it said, famous Hollywood film stars come to Denver. And that's really a true story. And I've done better in the auditorium here tonight, but I don't know that I've done that good with the press, have I? Anyway, so much for religion. We'd now like to, for our final offering, do something that we usually do at just about every concert, and it's a thing of fun, joy, and insanity, and all those things that I hold dear to me. And we hope that we'll be able to entice you and magnetize you into this whole kind of thing, as well as all of us up here. And our way of saying thank you for having us at this really groovy scene, I think it's wonderful, and I think that Lee Burns and everybody is really to be congratulated, especially seeing as the party is back on again.
It is, isn't it?
Okay, so for our final offering, here's Hey Jude. Thank you very much. You're really a wonderful audience, and particularly because you're all trumpet players. And so I love you all very dearly, and I really have enjoyed the 2 days that I've been here. And I only regret that I can't be here for the rest of the week, but I can't afford to lay the band off for 4 nights. So I do thank you all very, very much for being so wonderful this evening, and I hope I'll see you all again real soon.